Hey, everybody. Just a show of hands. Who all is disappointed that I'm not, in fact, Chuck Norris? Yeah, I know. A pretty big letdown for everybody who thought I was a big, beefy guy. So I guess I'd just like to start off by thanking some of the people that helped me on the way down. So let's see, we had Spencer, who was the first runner that I ran into. Very helpful guy, ran down, jogged with me, got to talk with him, kept me calm. And then Noah and Rachel. So yeah, Rachel was the lady that drove me to the hospital, kind of kept me calm. We talked during the car ride there. And then Noah, who was just a champ, went and got my truck, drove it to the hospital, dropped off my things so I could have my phone and contact my loved ones and let them know that a weird thing happened, but that I was okay. So I really appreciate their help. And then, of course, just my friends and family through all this. They've been really supportive and incredibly nice. So,
can you move the microphone a little closer?
Sure.
You need to turn that off.
All right. So, yeah, thank yous aside, I guess I can take some questions now.
Can you tell us your experience from beginning to start? From the start to the end.
From the beginning to the end.
We'd like to hear it, not after relying on the video that we just saw. We want to hear you. What was your experience?
Okay. So my experience as, I know you guys saw the video, but in person. So I decided to go for a run last Monday, February 4th. It was around noontime. I wanted to go on a pretty long scenic run. I headed up to Laurie State Park, and I kind of had a predetermined route that I was going to go on. And I knew that I wanted to do towers because I just wanted to give myself a hill challenge. So ran through the south side of Laurie State Park, which is a couple miles, and then linked up with Towers Road, which is a really steep 4x4 road. It's about 9% grade on average, and it's a little under 3.5 miles to the top. So running up, successfully got through the run and felt pretty good. Up at the top, I was able to look around and really take in some of the views. So up there you can see Fort Collins and the Front Range to the east, and then to the west you can see the rest of the mountain ranges and the Rockies kind of descending into space. So it's super pretty, get a good 360 panorama. And at that point, I was planning on running south to actual Horsetooth Rock Peak, which is just the really iconic rock that you'll see on the east side of town when you look at the skyline. But I encountered some ice on the trail about a half mile in, so I turned back and then decided to peel off on the now infamous West Ridge Trail and cruise on that east ahead and hook back up with Towers and then head down. But about a quarter mile into that run, I ended up hearing some pine needles rustle, like a stick break, and I turned around and just was pretty bummed out to see a mountain lion chasing after me. So I stopped and I threw my hands up in the air and I started shouting, and unfortunately, the shouts didn't deter it, so it just kind of kept running and lunged at me. It was going toward my face, so I threw up my hands to kind of block my face, at which point it grabbed onto my hand and wrist, and from there, it started to claw at my face and neck, and that's when kind of my fear response turned into more of a fight response, because I realized how close it was getting to my eyes, and it got a claw on my lip, and I tried to throw it off me at that point, and then we took a little tumble down the south side of the trail, and down there just kind of had a little wrestling match, at which point I was able to get on top of it, pin its back legs, so I didn't get any soft tissue scratched out in my nether regions, and at that point, I was grabbing around for sticks. I only had my left hand free. My right hand was still locked in its jaws. Tried to to get at its neck to see if I could stab it in the neck to get it to release. That wasn't working. The sticks were breaking. So then I picked up a rock that I had seen kind of near us. It was pretty heavy and it was kind of hard to wield. And I tried to give it a few bashes in the back of the head. But fortunately, I just kind of had a tough time swinging it with my arm still locked into the cat's jaws. Really wasn't working too well at that point. I knew with two pretty good blows to the back of the head that it didn't release, that I was probably going to have to do something a little more drastic. And then I was able to kind of shift my weight and get a foot on its neck. And at that point, I stepped on it, on its neck with my right foot. And just slowly, after a few minutes, I thought I'd be getting close, and then it'd start thrashing again, and had a few more scratches that resulted from those thrashes at that point. And I'd say another couple minutes later, it finally stopped moving, and then jaws opened, and I was able to kind of scramble back up the hill and get the heck out of Dodge. It's hard to say. I mean, I guess in my mind, if I replayed it, it seems like a long time, but I would think maybe 10 minutes at most.
A lot of people who are attacked by other animals say that some of the most vivid memories they have are of what they heard and what they smelled. Can you talk about that?
I was actually kind of surprised about the silence of it. There really wasn't any growls that I was hearing. I didn't hear any sort of cat noises that I would normally associate with a wildcat. The smells, I don't really remember the smells. I remember looking down and seeing the claws, like, retracting and then coming out of its paws, and was just really looking at those because that's whenever the front paws were just kind of thrashing when I was on top of it. So it was really pretty visually intense, and I don't really remember that many smells, per se.
Did that cliche kind of saying of your life flashing in front of your eyes, did you have a moment like that, or was it just pure adrenaline?
It was just pure adrenaline. There was a certain point where I kind of just imagined being stuck on this hillside and eventually just having a cat gnaw at me, which is a creepy way to go. But for the most part, the adrenaline just kind of kept kicking back in those moments. One of my big fears throughout the whole thing was another cat coming along, because it was a younger cat, and I could tell that it wasn't fully grown, and I was just very concerned that mom was going to come out of nowhere, and at that point, that fight would be over pretty quickly.
Did you think you were not going to make it out of this, and after everything that you've been through, I got to know what you and Annie are doing.
there was a point where I was concerned that I wasn't going to make it out of it, and I think it might have been a mix of me tussling with the cat and it still clawing at me, and then thinking about another cat potentially coming along, and I just kind of had that wave of fear roll over me and thought that I could just end up there and stay there, and luckily, that wasn't the case, and I am able to spend Valentine's Day 2019 with my girlfriend, Annie. And let's see, tonight, I don't know, what are you thinking? mac and cheese?
Yeah. Somehow haven't gotten around to plans.
Yeah, we'll see.
Can you describe the pain of an attack like that?
The pain wasn't as intense as I would think it would be. That could also be for the fact that I just had really high doses of adrenaline coursing through my body. The thing that hurt the most was my wrist, and that's just where the cat had kind of latched on. And at one point, I just remember feeling jolts in my nerves and my fingers, just because one of the cat's tooth was inside the kind of meat of my palm, and I just felt it kind of hitting that nerve over and over again, so these two fingers were just kind of a little bit electric. And then it was grinding at, like, after I hit it in the head with the rock, it started grinding its teeth back and forth, and I could hear kind of ligaments and tendons shifting around in there, and that it hurt, but I also remember the sound of that was pretty disturbing. I was like, well, there goes all loss of function in my fingers, but luckily it's not the case.
What's it been like getting all of this attention? And has any of it been negative?
So far, everything has been really positive. I'm not a big internet guy, so I haven't really seen any of the negative stuff. It is weird getting all this attention. I don't know. It's kind of weird to feel kind of famous for like an unearned reason. It's very much like a situation of happenstance where like a wrong place, wrong time instead of an earned sort of degree of fame, I guess. So that's been pretty weird. I think that's going to be the hardest part is I will never be able to live up to the reputation. And maybe that's what has led to some of my reticence for actually coming out, because I don't know, the story is bigger than my puny form. So, yeah.
What do you think Chuck Norris would think?
Oh, man. Chuck would have come out without a scratch. You know him. And he'd probably have the tiger slung over his shoulders, too. Not a tiger, a lion, sorry.